Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to tell if you have a factory alarm or if you don't. A lot of people that have some sort of keyless entry system on their factory vehicles or that's something that's factory equipped tend to believe that they have a factory alarm or factory security system. So today I want to show you to double check on that, because a lot of people just think if they hit lock once and then they hit lock twice again, when they see the lights flash and they hear that horn honk, they automatically think they have some sort of security on the vehicle, when a lot of the times that's not the case. Alright guys, so I have two vehicles here. I have a 93 Camry and a 2006 Nissan 350Z. So both vehicles are equipped with aftermarket security systems. So I'm going to show you what a vehicle with no security from factory and what a vehicle with a factory security system, how you're able to tell between the two. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to turn on the ignition, don't run the motor, and roll the windows down. Next, we have to arm the system. So there are two ways to activate a factory security system. Either if you have the factory key fob, hit lock, hit it twice to get the confirmation just to make sure, or on vehicles where you don't have the keyless entry, we're just going to lock it manually with the key and the tumbler. Do not hit the button in the door, because that typically does not arm the system unless it has passive arming. So I heard all the other locks lock, so I know that if there is a factory security system, it would be activated by now. Next, we have to wait for the security system to cycle. So typically for most systems, I wait anywhere between 30 seconds to 45 seconds. Okay, now that we've waited for the system to arm, if it does have it, this is how you're going to test it. You're just going to go in, unlock it manually through the window as if you were a thief breaking in, and open the door. As you can see, nothing happened. No horn honk, no light flash, no nothing. Now to verify, you also maybe want to open up the passenger front door as well, because if your door pins are not working correctly, that may be why your alarm isn't working. The easiest way to see if your door pins are working is just to turn your dome light onto door and make sure that the light turns on whenever the doors are open. Some vehicles will also have a door jar symbol on the gauge cluster that will also give you an indication whether your door pins work or not. Door pins are a wearable item, and you want to always make sure that they work, just by checking to make sure your dome light turns on. Now, some vehicles have it, like on this Toyota out here, while a lot of other vehicles have it built into the striker and the latch. If you don't have a pin like the one I showed you earlier, then it's going to be built into the striker. Okay, let's try the Nissan now. Same thing, I'm just going to arm it or lock it using the key and the tumbler. So now we're going to arm the system. You see that the light has gone solid. That means it is arming itself, and once it starts flashing again, then the vehicle's armed. Okay, we waited our 45 seconds, and let's simulate breaking in. So as you can see, when I open the door, the horn honks, and we do have some sort of factory security on this vehicle. So what are the limitations of factory security? Well, typically they don't have optional sensors like shock sensors, so if you ever hit the vehicle, nothing happens. Let's see what the aftermarket system does. We can also install other sensors like proximity sensors and audio sensors. The audio sensors are typically used for when glass breaks, but it can also pick up other noises inside the cab. Here's another limitation of a factory alarm. So you may know someone, or you've seen it, or maybe it's happened to you where your key tumbler has been busted. Now, typically there's two reasons for this. If a thief can take a screwdriver, hammer it in, and turn it, one, hopefully they're going to unlock the door. That way they don't break the glass, because breaking glass makes noise, unless you know how to break it without making noise. And also, if you can turn it just right, it'll usually send a ground pulse to the factory alarm system, disarming it all at the same time. This is where it's cool having the aftermarket security, because the aftermarket security does not care about this trigger. While the factory alarm, it is the one of the two ways for arming and disarming it, and every factory security system has this set up. Whether you have a key fob or not, they will, if it has a factory security system installed, it is going to disarm through here. With our factory alarm, we heard the horn go off, which made a pretty good amount of noise. Now, there are noise pollution laws that we have to adhere to, so security systems can't go on for minutes on end. They can typically only go for, they're only typically set for 30 to 45 seconds in between cycles. That way they adhere to noise bylaws. But let's see how loud the aftermarket system is. So as you can see in here, it activates the lights, and also the factory alarm kicks in at the same time, and also ours kicks in with the horn, so that's why the horn does a little different pulses, plus the multiple sirens in the vehicle. And if you're wondering what that is, I'm getting notification on my phone that the alarm system was, or the security system was activated. So let's go on my phone and check out the app and see what notifications we got. So if we just go to our smart start, and it's notifying me that my alarms were triggered. So you can set up your phone differently, so I actually have it set up through the app and also through text messages. Just in case the app doesn't send it to me, I will get a text message. So I get dual verification. Now, you can turn off and on notifications on these apps, but it's nice to know that you can. If I'm out of range from my remote, which is about one mile, as long as my car has cell phone coverage and I have cell phone coverage, I will be notified about the vehicle. Well guys, hopefully this video helped you out and helped you figure out whether you have a factory security system or not. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way, at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus, with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section, and it keeps applying it to different vehicles.